Hey guys, this is Mitch with Fine Point CGI, and today we're going to talk about how to create a very basic color changing shader for your game inside of Godot. So we're going to talk about how to take a grayscale image and then make a shader so that we can color that grayscale image in any color that we want. This could be really nice if you want to make a multiplayer game where you need to have multiple colors of a sprite, or if you have items that are owned by a single person and you want to make sure that you color that sprite specifically for that person and things like that. So it serves as a good introduction to kind of how shaders work and what they do. So that's what I have in store for you guys today. Let's go ahead and get started. All right, so the first thing we need to do is we need to come into our node and create a node 2D scene. We're going to go ahead and drag in the Godot SVG here. And what we'll do is we'll come down into our material, and we'll do a new shader material. Now inside of here, we're going to create a new shader and we'll go ahead and just call this color change shader.gd shader. And basically what it's going to do is it's going to be a canvas item. Now I don't need most of this because most of this is useless to me. So I'm going to pull these guys out. They're not going to be helpful for us because all we're going to be doing is changing the color of a grayscale image, right? So this shader will work with any type of grayscale image. So what we're going to do is we're going to type uniform sampler 2D grayscale image. Now this is going to be the grayscale image. So you can see right here in our shader preferences, we have a grayscale image. So we'll drag that guy in here and we'll have our nice little grayscale image. Now for us to load that grayscale image, what we'll do is we'll say vec4 grayscale texture is equal to texture grayscale image comma UV, and that's going to basically tell Godot that we want to load this image into a vector 4, and then we're going to map it to a UV coordinates, so that way it actually maps with the coordinates of these directions here, so it'll actually map it so it fits correctly, if that makes sense. And then what we can do is we can come in here and say float grayscale value is equal to grayscale texture dot R. So that way we just pull back the R value of that gunpowder right there, and that's it. And then we're going to also want to pull back our alpha value because we want to cut out our alpha. So we'll say float alpha value is equal to grayscale texture dot A, like that. And for us to actually have some kind of color, we need a vector 4 to create our color value. So we need to say vec4. So think of vec4 as the R, G, B, and A values. So we can come in here and say mix grayscale value. And you'll see that it's going to be mad at us, right? Because it wants us to mix multiple float values. So what we'll do is we'll create some colors. So we'll say uniform vector 4 low color, and we'll make that a type source color, like that. And then I'm going to copy and paste that twice, and I'm going to say mid color and high color as well. And you're going to see in a second that Godot will refresh and we'll have some additional parameters down here. But what we'll do here is we'll just mix those values. So I'm going to come in here and say low color, comma, mid color, comma, gray scale value, like that. And then I'm also going to mix in the alpha and the high color. That way we can actually get some additional control over our color. So I'll say mix color comma high color, and then I'm going to do power gray scale value, comma, 2.0. I'll put a semicolon on that guy and a semicolon on that guy. And then I'm going to come in here and I'm going to say color is equal to color, like that. And you'll notice it's black. So now if we change this to white, though, you'll see that we have a white image, basically, right? So if we turn this to kind of like a blue color and a, I don't know, like another blue color and then black, you'll notice that we now have our grayscale image, but in blue, which is really cool. But we want to handle our alpha, right? We want to cut this out so it actually matches. So how can we do that? Well, that's pretty easy. All we need to do is say color.a multiplied by equal alpha value. And we'll drop in a semicolon. And you'll see it now cuts out the alpha as expected. So what's really cool about this method is now I can come in here and I can make all of my outline white. I can also make it black. I can come in here. I can change my mid color as like a red color. And I can make my high color a yellow color. You can see it mixes all of those colors up. So that way we can get whatever colors we want. This could really help with reducing the amount of sprites that you guys have. So you might be asking how this works. So basically how this works is relatively simple. We get our grayscale image. We identify four different colors. And then, we identify three colors. And then we come in here and we actually load that grayscale image in as a texture and we map it to the UV of this object. And since this is a picture, it's just a flat plane, right? So it's just a flat UV object. Then we grab our R value of our grayscale image. So that way we can just get the intensity of the different colors values. And the reason why is R is one of the best channels to pull that information from. It has a lot of data in for grayscale images. Then we grab our alpha value because we need to be able to cut out our actual sprite. Then we come in here, we mix in our low color and our mid color with our grayscale value. Could we have mixed the high color in here? We could, but this allows us to get some bias here. So we're basically allowing us to have this second mix here, and we're mixing the low and the mid with the grayscale value first because that's the one that we want to kind of take precedence. And then we're mixing a high color with a power value. If we adjust this power value to something like 1, you'll see how it changes the color. If we change it to 5, you can see how it kind of changes the bias, if that makes sense, of our high color to the rest of the stuff. Now, a 2 to me just seems like the better value, but that's basically why this exists. Is it's just to give us a little bit more flexibility with how our colors get mixed. And then we pop out that alpha value so that it doesn't show that black boundary within our low color. It cuts out the alpha for our stuff. And then we finally apply that color of our material. And that is basically how you create a shader to help spread your sprites out. So you only have to create one to do multiple different sprites. Hey guys, Editor Mitch here. So something that I've neglected to mention in the tutorial is you can actually change your filtering method of a sampler 2D. And remember, a sampler 2D is just your texture. When you want to change the filtering, like you can see how blurry these guys are right here. So we can hit a colon and then type filter, and you'll see that we have a bunch of different filters here. We could choose linear, which will give us kind of this look. We can do filter mipmap, which will allow us to have mipmaps and things like that. Those are good for textures and things like that. And then finally we can do linear or nearest. And you will see that that gives us that nice pixel art look that we're really trying to go for. So I just thought I'd cover that so that way you guys knew how to actually solve that issue. So anyway, let's go ahead and jump back to the video. So I know this isn't my normal content, but I figured that it would be good for me to go over this because somebody asked it in the Discord and I wanted to cover it for people who might have that question in the future and why it works. So if you like this video, go ahead and hit that like button. Hey, you know, if you dislike this video, go ahead and hit that dislike button because I'm here to make content for you guys. This video was kind of a viewer suggestion, but it was more of a question than a actual suggestion. But if you have any suggestions, please leave them in the comments below or jump on my GitHub. Link is in the description and I'll be more than happy to take a look at it. And hey, if you have any questions about this or really any questions at all, leave a comment below or jump on my Discord. Link is in the description. And anybody there will be more than happy to help you out. But that is all I have for you guys today. So thank you so much again for watching. And I'll see you all next time. Thanks.